Name something that has white balls. Derek.
Ping pong.
Ping pong. One answer.
Yeah. Golf.
Golf. Pass or play?
We're gonna pass, Steve.
You're gonna, boy, y'all do that a lot. They're gonna
We're
pass.
Gonna pass.
All right.
Hey, Michelle.
Steve,
how you doing?
I'm doing very well.
So how's it been married to this soldier for 21 years?
It's been absolutely fabulous, Steve.
All right, Michelle, let's go. Name something that has white balls.
I would say softball.
Softball.
Yeah!
Kim, how you doing?
Wonderful. Good. How are you, Steve?
All right, Kim, name something that has white balls.
Cotton. Cotton balls.
All right, big fella, name something that has white balls.
I'm gonna say polo.
Polo.
That's right, polo.
Polo. Mel, how you doing, darling?
Great, how are you?
Good, you ready?
Mm-hmm.
You got two strikes, you gotta be careful. Finch family can steal. Name something that has white balls.
Foosball.
Foosball. Foosball. Family, here we go, Taffy. All right, here's your chance, ladies. Name something that has white balls.
Volleyball.
I don't know. Volleyball. Number seven.
Pool table.
Six. That's the worst answer we've ever flipped over, man. I was thinking it, but I was hoping it wasn't up there. Number five.
Christmas tree ornament.
Three.
Sewing.
All right, guys, let's go. We've doubled the point values here. Top seven answers on the board. When you were a kid, name something you used as a partner to practice kissing. Jeff.
Sister. She's never gonna forgive me for this either.
No, she's not.
Lindsay, you're not the sister.
No.
Where's your sister right now, Joe?
Probably hiding somewhere.
Is she in the building?
Or hunting for a weapon.
They got a new device now. It's called YouTube. You're gonna be a major star, Joe.
I'm sure.
Jeff, his sister. Yeah. Well, you got seven other people gonna be in the same room in hell with you. 20.
A pillow.
A pillow? Wow. Pillow. Oh, okay. Wow.
They're gonna play.
They're gonna play. Yeah. Hey, Jeff. Hang in there, man. That was a good answer. I've never heard that. I didn't know that. It's really smart. Heidi, when you were a kid, name something you used as a partner for practicing kissing.
Use your hand.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I was so somewhere else. Use your hand. Ooh. Mackenzie, let's go. When you were a kid, name something you used as a partner to practice kissing.
I'm gonna say a stuffed animal.
A stuffed animal. This is actually fascinating to me. Because I don't know any of this. The pillow really threw me off. And it was number one. So, hey, Taffy, let's go.
I'm going to go with another neighbor kid.
One of the neighbors. Come here, boy. Ramsey, let's go. Only one strike. When you were a kid, name something used as a partner to practice kissing.
A doll?
There you go, baby.
A doll. You guys are rolling. 20, it all started with you and the pillow.
Sounds a little strange, but how about the mirror?
Good answer.
The mirror.
Man.
I know.
You see how we're pregnant?
Y'all was having a good time. No wonder y'all pregnant. Y'all were just so good and tried everything. Been all in the mirror down there with the little girl down next door. You got a baby doll in your hand. Come here, give me that animal right here. You just been in the house practicing. Woo. I bet y'all stuffed animals is laying on the bed like, yeah. Oh, yeah. I got to be the luckiest bear in the world. Because you're all attractive girls. I'm sitting at y'all's house going, what a life. Hey, Steve, what are you? I'm a stuffed animal. Don't you wish you were something else? Uh-uh. They'll be home in a minute. What y'all working on today? We doing pregnancy today. You only got one strike, but you only got one answer left. When you were a kid, name something you used as a partner to practice kissing.
We're gonna say a sucker.
Good answer. Good job. Good answer.
This explains it. You know this explains
it,
don't you? Y'all got all the answers. That's on the board. I will. A sucker. Two strikes, McKenz. Got to be careful. Pippin family can steal. Yeah, go on, say it. I want to hear this.
Orange.
An orange. What? What y'all doing at your house? You got a pillow? You got this poor baby doll need therapy? You in the mirror? You using your hands? And that stuffed animal is waiting on y'all to put all that mess down. I'm ready. Come on, baby. Let's do it. An orange. Name an occupation in which you'd find a lot of neurotic people. Sonya.
Striptease dancer.
Striptease dancer.
Yes.
Okay, yeah, well, let's see. Striptease dancers. Jennifer?
Porn star?
A porn star. What's happening here? A porno star? Really? Really? A porn star is an actor. Have you ever seen a porno flick before? It's the worst acting people on the planet. They're not. Congratulations. Play or pass?
Pass.
They're gonna pass it.
Thank you.
Thank you. You started it.
No.
Talking about the strippers. Go over there and play. Name something a man might have in his pants when he's going on a hot date. Taffy.
Condom.
Condom, it's okay, it's a hot date. Condom.
Pass it down. We're gonna play.
They gonna play. Ramsey, tell me something a man might have in his pants when he's going on a hot date.
He's gotta have money.
Gotta have money. Twani?
I'm not locking, so we better have some keys.
Better have some car keys. Heidi, only one strike, darling. Tell me something a man might have in his pants when he's going on a hot date.
Breath mints.
Breath mints. Hey, Mackenzie, darling.
This may be inappropriate, but
And maybe he's excited to go on his date?
Uh-huh.
I have to be more specific, don't I?
Yeah, because I ain't never put no excitement in my past. Go ahead, Mackenzie.
Boner.
Huh?
Really upset again?
What did you say?
Boner.
You can say that on TV? You can say that on TV? What are y'all clapping for? You said boner! You said, you didn't ask me if you could say that. You said it, and then you said, do I have to make you say it again? I didn't make you say it in the first place. Let's get this clear. This was Little Miss Fassie's answer. Oh, this show ain't gonna make it 3 years. I'm gonna be off the air. When Richard Dawson did this show, I never heard stuff like this. I don't remember any of this. Now, 2011, 2012, y'all just say what you wanna say. Now I gotta turn around. I've gotta find a Christian way to say what you just said. Let's just say, someone is saluting the troops. Hey, how y'all doing? Let me tell y'all something. Look at the last one that just went up. A pitch tent. Don't say that when you come out the hole. Ready, break. All right, Taffy. Wow, name something a man might have in his pants when he's going on a hot date.
I'm gonna say some cologne so you keep smelling nice.
Some cologne. Ramsey, you gotta be careful, Dolly. You got 2 strikes. Walkers have a chance to steal.
Chapstick?
Chapstick. Walkers, you're gonna have to come up with it. Here's your chance. Name something a man might have in his pants when he's going on a hot date.
We're gonna go with the hotel room key.
Yeah! Yeah. A hotel room key. Number 6. Number 4, this poor guy. On the board. We asked 100 married men, which of the 7 dwarfs describes your wife in bed? Terry!
This is just to get up on the boards. Bashful?
Bashful. Bashful! Is topic, Michael. You control it.
We're playing.
They're gonna play it.
All right.
Come on, you got it.
There's a guy over there that this meant nothing to him. Tell me a word a married man would use to fill in the blank. I would blank for sex. James.
Pay.
That is a sad, sad very statement
very sad
about married men.
Completely agree.
So completely true. Bethany.
Cook. Clean.
I would lie for sex.
Yes. That's a guy answer. You don't know how deep this runs with us. You would lie. Yes, lie.
I've never done this, but beg.
Yes.
I would never do that. Don't have to.
Yes.
Don't have to.
Yes. Beg. my question. They don't even know.
I guess not.
Two strikes. No chance you can blow this, James.
I'm going to kick it up a notch and say, kill.
I would kill. Yes! Kill! Yes. Boulay family, get ready to steal.
Now, this isn't me. I would cry for sex.
Baby, did you let the two women down there influence your answer? Yes, you did. Why would you do that? This is a guy question. You want some big dude laying on her crying? Number four. Die. We'll buy it. We'll kill you about it. We'll beg you for it. We'll lie about it. And at the end of the day, we'll lay down our life for it. Something a burglar would not want to see when he breaks into a house. Rob.
Naked grandma.
Naked, huh?
I don't want to see that either.
I know you're right, okay? Nobody wants to see a naked grandma, but what are the chances of you breaking in the house and running up into your grandmama naked? Looking for a naked grandmama in the house, outside, in the woods, on the blanket. That's the occupant person that's there. All right, guys, here we go. We got the top six answers on the board. Name something that gets passed around.
Oh,
Chris.
A joint.
A joint? Yeah. Yeah. Now, Chris, I don't know what 100 people you thought we were talking to at some nice little mall across good old America, but I'm pretty sure the people didn't tell the survey people, hey, an illegal drug. Let's turn around and see how many weed heads are out there with Chris. A joint! This is when you know we're going to hell. Okay, Tracy, only four answers topic, so.
The collection played at church.
Now she's got the halo, and I got the horse.
I like the way you tried to stop us from going to hell. You, Mr. You Evil Boy, passing around the little thing with this funny smell. Looking for some saving here. Church plate. Oh. It's less than the joint. This is not good. I'm just gonna do, you just go over there. They're gonna play this.
Yes, we are.
If you have a big enough casket, name something you really can take with you. Chuck.
Money.
Money! Sheree.
A pet.
You're dead. So you're gonna just kill your pet because you didn't make it? Oh my goodness. Oh, let's hope Peter's not watching this episode here. Your dog.
Hey,
I'm just not understanding these 100 people.
Maybe the pet was already dead. You
Maybe the pet was already dead.
And you stuffed him.
And you stuffed him?
Yeah.
What the hell are you talking about? Give me Lacey Von Erich. Give me Mick Foley. Hi, darling.
Hi, Foley.
Here we go. Top 5 answers on the board, everybody. Name something you might see a squirrel at the park doing with it. Lacey.
Eating nuts.
Eating nuts.
Show me nuts. Yeah!
Okay, here's the whole question. Name something you might see a squirrel at the park doing with his nuts.
Family show.
Let me see, storing them.
Storing?
Yeah!
Wow, pass or play?
Yeah. I think we're gonna pass.
They're gonna pass it, ladies. Pass. Wow. It's a tough one, ladies.
Oh my gosh, that is tough.
Yeah, it is. It is. And it's gonna be tougher for me to say this 5 times. Something you might see a squirrel at the park doing with his nuts.
Play?
I'm sorry, guys. Play with
them. Yeah! Good answer! Play with your nuts! Come on, Steve! Have faith in me. Have faith in me.
Please. I see him doing that all the time.
Yes.
Play with his nuts? Yeah. I do, too.
I was talking about Steve.
Playing with some...
Sorry.
Christy?
Okay. Finding them.
Oh, that's good.
Finding them.
Oh.
Two strikes. If it's not their velvet, the wrestlers are gonna get a chance to steal.
Taking them to its tree.
Taking them to the tree. Two strikes.
Defending his nuts.
Yes. Yeah. Defending them.
Crack them open. Crack them open. Crack them.
Here we go. Name something you might see a squirrel at the park doing with his nuts.
Cracking them open.
Yeah. Cracking them open. We'll be right back if we still have a show.